This is Evan Abrams, and let's talk about cutting, copying, and pasting keyframes. It's important to talk about this because I've really noticed that a lot of people aren't doing it well or correctly, or there's a lot of confusion about how keyframes are cut, copied, and pasted, or what's actually happening when you're cutting, copying, and pasting keyframes, and etc., etc. And I know it's confusing, and some people even can't find where the keyframes go, but I'm going to try to walk you through some easy tips for better saving of your time with the old copy and paste. Just like when you're writing essays for school, copying and pasting is probably the most useful tool that you'll ever use. So just looking here, I'm just going to tell you right now, I only ever created one set of motion, and I copy and pasted it every time I use it. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 things, all animated using one thing, so divide the amount of time I would have wasted keyframing all of them by 6, and you've got time savings. In fact, doing this whole intro here took me about, I'll say 8 minutes? Probably, maybe less than 8 minutes. You know, I'm pretty good at stuff. All in? Cutting, copying, and pasting is going to save you a lot of time. Let's get into how that goes and exactly what kind of information you're using when you do this stuff. So I'm just going to make a new comp, start over fresh. Okay, we're going to go new, solid, whatever. I'm going to go new text layer. And I'll just type out at EC Abrams, which is my Twitter handle, so that you're forced to stare at that the whole time. Right now, we're only going to look at the composition and timeline panels, so we're just looking at these. Everything else is superfluous, so let's try to just keep it all focused here on this one thing. And we're going to animate only a couple of properties. So let's just animate a bunch of them. Let's animate the scale. Let's animate the rotation. Maybe we can animate the opacity as well, just because we need some examples. Let's start the opacity down at 0, let's start the rotation at 90, and let's start the scale down at 0 as well. Click the stopwatch here, and okay, let me back up a little. Look at the layers, and look right here at this arrow that's pointing, you know, at the layer. When you click that, it's going to open up, and it's going to show us everything inside that. This is called twirl down. So anytime I say twirl down, that means click on this arrow, it'll go from pointing to the right. Yes. Twirl down into this, and then twirl down into other things will get you deeper into stuff. It's basically saying within this layer are these two things, within those things are more things. And then you get into these, which are the properties. And you can shortcut to them by hitting like S for scale, or you can hit U and bring up everything with keyframes. You can hit UU and bring up everything that you've changed. But that's how you access this stuff. So in order to access keyframes, if you want to see all of them, just hit U. If you know what you're looking for, hit the letter. Scale is S, rotation is R, opacity is T for some reason. Opacity? Remember that? But that's how you access your keyframes. I'll move ahead, and I'm going to set some by altering the data a little bit. I don't know, 200 maybe. Let's set the rotation to 0, and let's set the opacity to 100. So we have this, which is not overly interesting in any way, shape, or form, but, you know, we're working on it. So now I'm going to take these. I hit F9 to make them easy eased. If you're familiar with my love of the motion graph here, then we're gonna get a little fancy. I'm just gonna alter the motion of these. If you want to see a radical tutorial about how to use this effectively, then I highly recommend you check out that tutorial. It's one of mine, it's pretty good. Just make these a bit sharper, and that's slightly more interesting. Okay, and I'm just going to affect the anchor point. This is totally superfluous to the tutorial. Okay, so we have these here keyframes, and let's say we make a new layer, you know, it could be anything. It could be tweet me or something stupid like this as well. We want to apply the same motion to this. In fact, we want to apply, you know, whatever we did to this thing, to that thing. So we do that by clicking and dragging a box around all of the keyframes. That's one way to select them. So step one, select the keyframes. You can click and drag a box. You can select this, you can click the property, hold down shift, click, you know, when they go from being gray to being yellow, you have them selected. When you select a property, it goes from light gray to gray, indicating you are selecting it. So you can select them all. I use Command C. You can use Control C if you're on a Windows machine. You can go edit, copy, that kind of thing. You can cut them. Same functions as you have in other things. So copy and then select another layer and paste. What happened? It disappeared. Evan, what's going on? Whenever you copy and paste things, it's important to remember that I select all of these, I've selected from here to here, and now I'm pasting, and when it pastes, the first keyframe it pastes is going to be this one. So you see how it's just kind of shifted over like this? That's because the earliest keyframe goes here. Here, let's undo that. Okay, let's say hypothetically that our keyframes are sort of moved in this sort of a way. So they're kind of staggered, right? So I don't know why you'd do that, but it could create interesting motion for you. If I copy all of these, and then I go to this layer and I paste them, the earliest keyframe goes at the playhead, which is where this red line is, and then the rest of them after it. So it's taking this block and it's sticking the first keyframe here, the rest of them follow. Okay, so if I want to have this motion be exactly the same, I have to make sure the first keyframe lines up with the first keyframe of this, which means put the playhead at the beginning, and then you're all good. See? Totally the same. Good for us. Way to go. So that's also not exactly what we wanted to do, because we don't really need the scale to go up that much, only to 100 or whatever. It doesn't really matter at this point. But one of the most common mistakes with keyframing that I've seen is that people get confused when they're pasting, or they don't know what they're copying, or it gets befuddled in that fashion. So, you know, that's one thing to remember about keyframing stuff and copying and pasting. Another thing, let's say I select the opacity property, right? And then I copy it, and then I paste it here. It's pasted opacity to opacity, so that's good. But what if I select rotation and hit paste? Whoa, I copied from opacity to the rotation. So you can do that as well if you want to take some data and then move it somewhere else. You can see what that's done is it's taking the rotation from 0 to 100 because the opacity's value is 0 to 100. So it's important to remember that what you're copying and pasting, it's really just a bunch of numbers, and you can put those wherever you want. Let me just quickly call up the old text edit here. What happens if I just paste this into a text editor? After Effects keyframe data, units per second, source width, source height, source pixel aspect ratio, bunch of information about the source, and the information is transform scale, the frame is 11, la 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 la, la 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 la. That's about it. So this stuff, when you copy it and then paste it, After Effects somehow knows what this is and then crams it into stuff. This is showing your start values and then your end values. So it starts on frame 11 at 000 and then ends on frame 31, 200, 200, almost 200? Weird. And that's the end of it. So when you copy and paste this, you're transposing that information into something else. Here, let's get a little bit weirder, if you don't mind. What if we took a scale thing, and then I pasted that into opacity? Ooh, it's error time. So anytime that you're going to take something that is of a larger dimension than the thing you're pasting it into, you're going to get errors. That means, like we saw in the text edit file, it has 0, 0, 0, and then 200, 200, almost 200, and it's trying to cram that into something that only has space for one of those, so it gets confused, it doesn't know what you want, error. What if we took something that has only the one, it's only going from 0 to 100, we copy that and we paste it into the scale. Ooh, same error going from 1 to 3. So that doesn't work. So just remember that when you copy and paste things, either if you want to take the same property and apply it to the same property, just select the layer and it does it by default. And remember, the playhead is where it starts at. So I'm Evan Abrams. Thank you for watching this tutorial that is about copying and pasting of keyframes. I hope that this helps you out. I've seen a lot of questions in the comments sections about copying and pasting of keyframes and about how to copy and paste in general. Just remember, copy and paste the same as you do in other apps. Pasting starts at the playhead, and that's about it. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, tell your friends. If you want to learn other stuff, let me know what you want to learn, and I'll try to help you out as best I can. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.